All right, well, back here in the well-hunted park, and I think I have silver. I think right there, looks like a mercury dime. Well, I'll look at the date, and then I'll show you a close-up. 1937. It's a mint mark, 1937D. So, first silver today. Not many signals. I have a few wheats. 1910, 1917D, 1918, 1940s, but this is my first silver, and I'll keep looking and see what else I can find. Hey everyone, I absolutely do not believe this. I've been in this park probably, I've come here hunting about 5, 6, 7 times, and I barely ever find any signals. It's so trashy, full of iron, really old park. I've been here about 5 minutes, got kind of a high-pitched signal, like sort of repeatable, but really surrounded by trash. Usually it ends up being a nail in this park. Anyway, I dug down and got a silver right here. It's a barber dime. Holy crap. Can't believe it. I'm going to get the macro on. It's really crusty. I don't have any water, so I'm not going to rub it right now. Looks like it's in good condition, so if I see a date, I'll show you guys. Otherwise, show it to you later when I get it cleaned up. All right. There it is. Yeah, you can see it's a barber. Just see the edge of the nose, and in the back you can sort of see the one dime coming through. Sorry, I got some really harsh sunlight right here. Anyway, kind of hard to see, but definitely a barber dime. Good condition. I'll clean it up later and see what date it is, but that's a really good start. Okay, back in the old park, and really bad day today as far as signals go, but I decided to start looking at some trashier signals, and from about 3 or 4 inches, looks like I got a buffalo nickel here. So just pulled it out of the hole, not too deep, but really packed in among trash. I'll get a macro lens here and show you a close-up. All right, looks like a 1935 buffalo nickel. It's in decent condition. It's got a date. So, don't see a mint mark. It's pretty dirty though. It's my 9th buffalo nickel for the year. About 2 or 3 inches. Maybe 3 or 4. Not real deep, but that's a really good find. I'll show you if I find anything else. It's been about 40 minutes since I last found something. And just kind of digging really iffy signals, because that's about all that remains in this park. So, got a real choppy signal about 6 inches down, and as I started digging down, it sounded like a wheat from above, but when I got down there, it started to get higher pitch, and I was like, oh boy, looks like silver. So I think we have silver here. Let me put the macro on. If you could see that, it says one right there, and it looks like a mercury dime. Stuck in the dirt. Right there, yep. So I'll pull it out of there and see if I can show a date on here for you guys. Alright, you can see that there. 1920. Really nice early mercury dime. It's pretty worn, but not as worn as some of them come out, so it doesn't look like it has a mint mark either. So 1920 Philadelphia, about 5-6 inches. Real iffy signal, but it paid off. I'll show you if I find anything else. All right, back again. Another day, but I'm about 10 feet away from where I found the mercury dime, 1920 mercury dime, and I got about a 2-3 inch nickel signal, very shallow. Turns out it's only about 2 inches down, and pulled it out here, and I already looked at it a little bit. Looks like a 1904 V nickel. Let me get the macro on here and show it to you. Okay, I was wrong. It's actually a 1901. 1901 V nickel right there. It's really dirty right now, but you can see the date. And it's decent condition, but really shallow signal, and I passed over this, I'm sure, because didn't realize it was something this old would be this shallow, but that happens in this park. Alright, that's a good find. See what else I can come up with today.